Writer and journalist Maryse Wolanski and Georges Wolanski were together for 47 years until the attack on Charlie Hebdo separated them. She has just published a book investigating the circumstances. She has called it Chérie, je vais à Charlie.
Ce titre est les dernières paroles.
The title is the last thing my husband said.
La journée commençait.
The day started out normal, like every day.
Banalement, avec. Enfin, banalement, non. Après
well, not that normally after all. We talked about what we had on for the day. Then we were getting ready, and my husband came to tell me. I was wrapped up in a bath towel, and he said, "Darling, I'm going to Charlie."
Je vais à Charlie. Bon, voilà. Et puis moi, je suis allée.
I went off to a meeting, and I turned off my mobile phone.
Et donc j'étais,
during the time it happened, that terrible thing, the tragedy that I was going to be submersed in.
J'étais dans un taxi et
I was in a taxi when I saw my phone showing a lot of messages asking how George was.
Comment allait George? Donc je n'ai pas du tout
compris. I didn't understand, naturally. And so I asked the taxi driver a question and he said, "What was your husband doing?" I told him he was at Charlie Hebdo.
Et là, il m'a dit,
that's when he said, "Madam, I have to tell you, there's been an attack at Charlie Hebdo."
Et là, bien sûr, je me suis mise à trembler.
I started shaking. I lost my balance there in the taxi.
Oui, quelque chose basculait. Déjà quand j'étais dans le taxi, et puis il m'a ramené chez moi.
He brought me home, that kind taxi driver whom I'll never forget.
Et il m'a accompagné jusqu'à ma porte.
He accompanied me to my door with tears in his eyes and he said, "I will pray for your husband."
Pour votre mari. Bon. C'était pas la peine parce que mon mari.
There was no use in that though, since my husband was already dead. He'd taken four bullets and the first one had hit his aorta, so he died instantly. And that was a relief for me, if I can say that. Since my concern was that he would have been wounded and suffered and that he'd been frightened.
Et qu'il ait eu peur. Parce que quand
because
on
surely something must happen when you're faced with a Kalashnikov, or perhaps not, I don't know.
Mais voilà,
but anyway, that's what I was afraid of, and so was my daughter, because we knew our George very well.
Pendant la période du mois de décembre,
throughout the month of December, I found him very somber, and I asked myself, but why is that? And he talked a lot about dying. He would say, "What are you going to do when I'm dead? What's going to happen to you? I haven't protected you enough," even though he did protect me a lot. But it never occurred to me. I feel a bit guilty about that, actually. It never crossed my mind that there really were so many threats.
De me dire qu'il y allait avoir, qu'il y avait vraiment beaucoup de menaces, il m'en parlait pas du tout.
He never talked about it.
J'aurais su qu'il
if I had known that there were that many threats, I would have told him, "I don't want you to go." But well, I didn't know, and I certainly didn't imagine it. I really didn't.
Je n'ai vraiment pas imaginé.